Ja, dobro dan. Zdaj moram jaz nekaj. Aha, morate mi dati dovoljenje.
Okay. You have to...
Ja, bo Franci takoj uredil.
Let me share.
Okay. In zdaj, the, situacija
allow me to share my screen and the situation
imam jaz zdaj na voljo 17 minut,
that now I have 17 minutes available to explain
ne,
why
ne.
The world is as it is.
Sem vam napisala, mi smo prišli vas poslušati in vas bomo poslušali do konca.
Listen to you and we will stay with you
okay,
till
to
the end.
Okay, dela, vidite vse.
So
you
see
to vas, ko se napijete, pa vas ustavi policaj in reče,
when you are drunk and are stopped by the policeman, you see, do you see four carrots? Does it work? Yes,
paste,
it works.
Mislim, to,
now,
kar mene res, res
what
zanima, je
I am truly interested in is the widest possible view, because it's the most difficult one.
Pač narejeni, da parcialno,
we are made to see things partially specialized.
Ampak mene zanima najširši
however,
možni
I am interested in the widest possible view.
Da vam
and
pokažem,
I have few minutes to show you.
Kako smo prišli
and
do
the idea how we got to the present relationship to work. It will be quite quickly. I will speak fast. So, my apologies to the interpreter. If her, if she burns out, but this is a huge topic to put it into one focus, I think it's really difficult. Start with the quotes.
There
is a number of quotes on line. Freud said, love and work are important in work. So you probably read it. I can say just, I fully agree, but let's add a detailed look into this statement. This is my interpretation of Freud.
The
life is looking for balance between sensible work and sensible relationship. Love is equal sensible relationship. You have love for children, for your partner, and we are social beings, so we have relationships with people around us. And it is great to make this relationship sensible and looking at the balance between sensible work and sensible relationship that we are all looking for. Let's go back in time. I started as a programmer in times when we had highly primitive computers. You had to ask, how is it made before you started programming? And my question here was, how are we made before we start discussing theory? Looking to ancient history, to communities of hunters and gatherers that we lived 400,000 generations, not years, but generations. And our biology is made for that, to hunt and gather. And we have to be aware that we are using our biology. And the thing is that these hunter-gatherers groups used to work 2 to 3 hours a day, and the remaining time was socializing, chatting, hygiene, stories. So we are made to work 2 to 3 hours a day.
Tu sodobne raziskave kažejo, da lahko delamo 2 to 3 ure visoko osredotočenega ali pa ustvarjalnega dela,
and then 6 hours of rummaging around in the morning, and we can repeat it 2 or 3 times a day.
Ja.
Yes, and then it is truly interesting for me. In some countries, they have some experiments, and they cut working hours to 7, and productivity doesn't fall, and we rummage for around an hour less, so we can work for 3 hours. You need an hour for coffee and discussions, 2 to 3 intensified hours of work, and an hour to say goodbye and get from work. And my conclusion is 4 hours of work is enough. Going to ancient history of 400,000 generations, 2 hours a day for work, the rest was left for relationships. These are intimacy relationships. So the scale between work and relationships falls into relationships strongly. And let's see what is going on today with our scale. How are our relationships? US survey, parents and children have 3 to 5 minutes a week of sensible discussion. 3.5 minutes sensible discussion between parents and children. It's not to ask them what they did, where they went, and what they are eating and so on. Sensible discussion is to express your internal state. If you read White Should Be Washed at 90, this is a story of people who cannot express about social internal situations. And Slovenians have a problem with that. That's what I'm writing about in my columns. We are even worse than the Americans. And between spouses, I saw a manual about happy marriages. If you are talking 10 minutes a day, that makes your marriage happy. We are talking about minute quantities. That means that we failed in relationships. 3 minutes, 10 minutes a day.
In tehnica se je nagnila v delo.
Failed in relationships. So our scale fell into work. Without stability in our work, we move into in relationship, we move into work. Sensible work. Overwork causes 750 people to die, 1,000 people to die a year. So excessive work is a problem. How we got here? There are 4 reasons for that. First, egoism, values, work as punishment, and lost sense. And let me move through all the four. Okay, let's begin. Let's tackle the age of ego.
And
it requires a wider view. Human history is waving between collective and ego, between collective and individual, and back. And in 1960s, of course, Soviet Union, communism, it was a collective society, and on the other side, US, the hippies, collective hippies, of hippies, we had the rejection with Chicago Economic School, with Friedman in 1970, with well-known article that the only thing that the company should do is create profit. No responsibility, human social responsibility, just profit is the main motto.
Greed is good was their
motto. And since economy went there, science went and followed. Richard Dawkins wrote about selfish gene.
And this is the key, that
the person you love most is yourself. You have only your own genes. You have 100% your genes. You love your children 50%. When I read this 76, I found it colossal absurdity.
These are the stories about people who oziroma,
these are not the stories about people who would
risk their lives to sacrifice
a stranger. And the story about three men who tried to save a drowning dog, they three drowned and the dog survived. So this absurdity of the theory was obvious to me, but it became quite popular.
Google mentions
that the nomination for the best scientific book
is the selfish gene.
The gene is selfish and the the grid is good and the policy followed Margaret Thatcher with her statement, and you know there is no such thing as society. There are individual men and women and their families. Saying people are selfish and a person to lead the society with such an attitude, that's obvious. And not recently, the Catholic Church in Rome gathered the data which sins, mortal sins, people confess to. This was a global research in 1995. This was the last time when greed is one of the mortal sins. And then they lost it. This is the last greed on seventh place. And if a mortal sin stops being sin, becomes a virtual, something changes deeply in society. Let me just say how easy it is to be a man. Three main sins for men are lust, gluttony, and sloth. You just watch a porn and overeat on your couch and you are done as a man. So greed was lost as a mortal sin. And since it is no longer sin, the differences between pay, between the best pay and other people have started to grow and grow. And
workers have increased
their productivity, but their salaries in real terms have not grown since 1970s. The salaries fell and remain at the same position for the last 50 years. And the difference between the salaries of the majority of people and productivities and GDP growth, GDP is growing exponentially, but the salaries are growing and mobility has fully fell. And the least socially mobile country in the world is United States.
And this is a fairy tale. If you are there, you can succeed.
You have the least opportunity to get rich. And least opportunity in any other state, Scandinavia, you have more chance to do something, to make something of yourself. And this leads us to a modern society, deeply divided society. The difference between productivity and wealth went to the space of the rich people. The 50 richest Americans are worth as much as the poorest 150. Okay, to je en
vzrok za odnos dela, bom povedal krožno, drugo so zgrešene vrednote.
Gleda
to, da je pohleb dober in geni vas terajo, da nagrabite čim več, kot morate, ne?
Smo prišli do pravila, da če manj,
bolj koristite družbi, manj plačila boste za to
dobro. Kaj so dve raziskave,
leva je ameriška in je kombinirano nek indeks, koliko kdo koristi družbi.
Prvi je raziskovalec, index, the benefit for the society, researchers plus nine, teachers plus one, engineers, they are okay, lawyers are slightly bad for society, advertisers minus, managers minus, and financiers,
they hurt society.
And on the right-hand side, absolute amounts in pounds, banker in the city, 5 million pounds of the pay, causing 7 times more harm to the society. Tax advisor causes 11 times more harm for the society, and then it turns upside down, cleaner at the hospital is paid much less, but does 10 times good for the society. And
I read Financial Times this Saturday, In je tako smešno, ne. Iz tega citata, da so otroke v tretjem razredu osnovne šole sprašali, kdo več zaslužne, medicinska sestra, bankir, so otroci seveda rekli, ja, medicinska sestra, ne. In iz tega so napisali članek na dveh velikih stranih formata, kako so otroci finančno neizobraženi, da moramo v šolah zvišati njihovo finančno izobraževanje, ker moram biti jasno, da mora bankir ne primerno zvešati. Ne, ni pa nekomor tam zanimljeno, kako bo finančno nobeno, vse v neredakciji ni pa na pamet. Ker pa se vsem, kar nas res zanima in kar počnemo z veseljem, je element ustvarjalnosti in tudi igrivost. Ustvarjalnost sama po sebi je igrivost, ne more biti drugač. In če imate vi v sebi igrivost, imate in voljo do veselja in do sprememb in do življenja in do vseh. Ampak, pa ste zdaj, ne? Kako se je začela Amerika? Na ladji Mayflower so se zbrali puritanci, ki so ugotovili, da v Evropi ne bodo mogli narediti novega sveta in so šli delati novi svet drugače. Ampak puritanski svet prisega na trpljenje. In tu treba zelo vedeti, jaz to ni zdaj časa, da grem po razvoju puritanske misli, ki je izjemno močna v Ameriki. In z tem izjemno močna po celom svetu. Ker mi, ki beremo nek ameriški priročnik o poslu ali o čemerkoli, je to puritanizem o trpljenju in trudu not vključen. To morate vedeti. Naštel bi samo, omenil bi Thomasa Carlyla, da delo mora biti trpljeno. Delo mora biti njegov citat worship of sorrow, češčenje žalosti tuge. In delavac mora svojo službo nositi, kot je Jezus nosil svojo trnjevo krono.
Wear the crown of thorns for their company.
In tudi pri nas, tudi pri nas, če berete Simona Gregorčiča, ni praznik, predragi mi, naše življenje, ampak je delo v dan in vi ste rosni in potni. Slajša vas človeško trpljenje, edino, kar vam slajša bivanje. In zato seveda pridemo, kateri raziskave iz 4 let nazaj na konferenci mladih poslovnih žensk, dve tretjini udeležen ima zase ni 10 minut časa dnevno. Zdaj prvo možete, da to res, in to je grozak, ker pomeni, da dve tretjini teh poslovnih žensk so čisti zravnotežja med odnosi in med službi, totalno zravnotežja, ampak totalno. Drugo pa, da oni mislijo, da morajo to reči, They believe that they have to say this to be valued, to be praised, and they are lying. And if they are lying, it's horrible that we would value the fact that you lack 10 minutes a day for your private life because you constantly work. This would take another lecture, but if you value work as suffering, hard work, you You hate completion. Once you are completed, once you are done, what now? You can no longer suffer. And that is why let me serve this piece of data. In Slovenia, productivity per working hour, we are less than 80% at the EU average.
We are second by invested hours, but our productivity is
ker je treba trpeti na delu, ne pa učink narediti, nekaj pa jat na empir.
The effect is much lower than our hard work.
Ok. In zdaj ta kombinacija, kombinacija, ta neverjetna kombinacija puritanizma,
unimaginable combination between puritanizma, hard work, ego,
in je seveda vod do tega, do odnosa, ki ga imamo na delu. In to je najzadnja Galupova raziskava v 142 državah, 180 milijonov zaposlenih je odgovarjeno na vprašanje, ali vas vaše delo zanima.
Said, are you interested in your work? Yes, 13% of people are interested in the work they are doing. 63% say, I get paid and I don't care about my work. This is highly controversial. You cannot spend 8, 10 hours a day and I don't care what I do. What we do shapes us. And 63% of people lie themselves. And now pay attention.
24% people are
saboteurs. They are destructive in their work. Very interesting information. U.S. research on satisfaction. Two-thirds of people are unhappy. England research that was repeated in Netherlands as well. Do you believe if your job would be closed, would people notice it? 37% of people say, no, no one would notice that my job is no longer there. And at the Netherlands, 40% of people say that they do pointless work. 14 days ago, U.S. research covering Slovenia as well, two-thirds of people are suffering at their jobs, and two-thirds would requalify, would prefer to requalify, and only 27% of people agree with the values of their organization. Interesting to go with Friedman's motto that organizations follow profit.
And in this mixture, nezadovoljstva, ki je fascinantno,
area, we get to the constant dissatisfaction reflected in a number of ways. One is that 50 million of Americans believe they are allergic to modern life. They are being suffocated. They have psychosomatic illnesses, burnouts, not because overwork, because frustration, because nonsense, because stupidity. The average worker experiences career burnout by the age of 32.
And this is a similar, and of course,
arrogance of Elon Musk, who, of course, without unemployment support, earns billions. This is the overview of current situation, extreme dissatisfaction, frustration that is reflected everywhere for students who are required to present PCT proof. If you are dissatisfied, frustrated in your life, of course, you will blow out.
Izhodišče je, da ljudje hočemo opravljati smiselno in ustvarjalno delo. Ustvarjalno, kot se vedno vključuje elemente igre. In smiselno delo vedno vključuje družbo, torej družbo
koristo. In tukaj je učiteljno beneficial delo, ki je istinsko ustvarjalno, ker zmeraj vključuje družbo, da se je naredi. In zdaj udarila pandemija. In kaj je zdaj berete članke o tem, da so delovno izginilo? V Ameriki manjka na nekom desetine milijonov. Workers have disappeared. People are not going back to work. They left their jobs. And Amazon, you see 21% the sale of
musical instruments.
They are selling classical books. Anna Karenina is being read. 200% increase in learning languages and 40% of people have improved their digital knowledge. They had time to do that. And 77% of people want to do something else.
And this British survey, only
6% of UK public want to return to pre-pandemic economy, to same jobs, to same poor relationships. And now let me wrap up by saying,
да вас опозорим на, на неки, че можна да са неки правят плавец, модре тоне, то са неки култури на свето, къде е задоволство,
живление
най-више, кер за то е тут най-больше здравие и най-люди най-дължио. И то са те модре тоне, кер ни са многенно контакти, кер никой друга с друга.
Ампа,
те девет значимости, ки си усети делио,
първо е измерна физична активност, а вече са попарно от тисто, кам включуе друго
спутност. Сми са жуление и дело, ако са нека то е дело, ако включуе друго друго. Смерен стрес, пай стрес, стрес е доток новости.
Stress is influx of new things, where is not too little, when where there is not too much. Moderate number of calories, plant-based food,
moderate
intake of alcohol, a glass of wine with other people, not alone,
припадност дружини, и уключеност в дружбено живление.
Being involved in social life, being part of the family, part of the community,
and
every moment of every hour day we are looking for balance between sensible work and sensible relationships. And before the new year, it would be good to stop and see, do I live balanced life? Do I have good relationships, new friends? Do I take 10 minutes a day to talk to people around us?
In a sensible way, a few years ago,
director of a Slovenian company, when receiving the award, manager of the year, said, my company is more important to me than my wife and my children. This shows how this balance this person is. But this is the true New Year question. Unfortunately, I don't have a long beard, but still, ask yourself ahead of the New Year about the balance that you are looking for in your life. Thank you very much. Thank you all.